there is uneasiness. Actually, it could be termed as anger among a section of people here in Gulu City towards the remarks made by the Prime Minister Robina Nabanja.
This Mabati here, we want to tell Nabanja, the Prime Minister of this country, to be warned that all Mabati for Northern Uganda must come to Northern Uganda. You cannot replace what you have stolen from Karamoja with Mabati from Northern Uganda.
The Prime Minister, Robina Nabanja, is on record to have suggested that the iron sheets that have been designated for the vulnerable people in Northern Uganda be given to their counterparts in Karamoja as compensation for the widely publicized OPM Mabati that were allegedly given to politicians. This suggestion has not been well received in the region.
They are the one working towards creating more vulnerability on the ordinary people whose life is already threatened.
Ojibu Geoffrey Odong is a resident of Gulu City. He believes that giving iron sheets meant for Northern Uganda to Karamoja will only escalate corruption in the high offices.
He has already revealed that Northern Uganda also have iron sheet, and this iron sheet is meant for vulnerable people in Northern Uganda. We are just demanding, we are not requesting, we are demanding that the Minister for Northern Uganda, the State Minister for Northern Uganda, should receive all these iron sheets for Northern Uganda and invite all the chief administrative officers, RDCs, and then our political leaders. And these iron sheets should be handed over to the direct beneficiaries in the public open space.
The iron sheets scandal came to the limelight in the early 2023 when it was revealed that several top politicians, including some ministers and members of parliament, erroneously received iron sheets that were meant for the suffering people in the Karamoja region. To date, two ministers have been arrested by the police.
So people are disappointed with the way key actors in government make decisions. Some decisions should have been actually made by cabinet. This is a sign that there is a problem in the government implementation system of the government at very high echelons. My concern is that such activities amount to corruption and failure of intended government programs.
Peter Obina is a political analyst in the region. He is an astute supporter of the NRM ideologies, but he is also disappointed in the fact that corruption could stifle the economic growth of this country.
Most of the things being done in these war-torn areas is just aimed at meeting key objectives of peace and security, and they should be executed in total transparency with the full accountability by responsible persons.
Actually, we want full accountability. How many Mabatis were meant for the people of Northern Uganda? Our MPs, listen to us. We want the exact number for Northern Uganda, the exact number for Mabati for Northern Uganda. Nabanja, take this one very seriously, that we were not even aware that we have Mabati for our suffering people.
Northern Uganda has had poverty alleviation programs such as the NUSAF 1, 2 and 3, the Peace Recovery and Development Plan, also known as the PRDP, but little impact has been noticed. Speaking to me on the streets of Gulu, Oyarchaga Wilson sees loopholes in the reasoning of the Prime Minister.
The entire 22 members of cabinet and some members of MP getting into such very silly saga is unbelievable. I think it's upon that the president must now wail his sword.
As the iron sheets scandal rages on across the country, the Prime Minister has come out in defense that President Yoweri Museveni has declined her proposal. I'm Joseph Omagor, reporting for the news in Gulu City.